Greetings, hallucinations. I'm Jamal Papaga, and I'll be covering the Jace vs. Urgot top lane matchup. Now, it used to be that this was my favorite matchup of all time, because it was so skill-based. It was really a toss-up between whether Jace or Urgot would win, and I loved that. But then, He received some pretty serious nerfs, both direct and indirect, and it wasn't even a fair battle anymore. But now, with some new changes, he's seen a resurgence. So, it's back to its former glory, in part. Jace, however, overall I've discovered Urgot kinda counters him overall. 30 seconds split pushing. Urgot keeps Jace off of carries and teamfights. Jace overall is just too squishy. He can poke, I'll give him that, but aside from that, he doesn't serve much more of a purpose. Now, early on, we decided to invade the enemy red buff. This gave us knowledge on where Vi was starting, and potentially influenced her choice. Because of this, she decided to take blue buff, and that slows her clear time, and ultimately allows us to figure out the way we want our lanes to work. I guess that's how you can say it. So because Vi is starting blue, I decide to let Jace push early on. In the meanwhile, I keep my distance because Jace does have dominance at level 1. However, he's moving around the bushes, and that gets him out of Acid Hunter range, but it also disallows him from auto-attack harassing me. Usually if I get through the first level with only 100 lost HP, I tend to think of it as a one lane. So I match his leveling and get up there at level 2 at the same time. Miss noxing corrosive charge, so I'm forced to back up, otherwise I could take a considerable amount of damage, and I just leave it up to him to push it to me. In the meanwhile, I can still see us with Acid Hunters from far if he threatens me. My cat's walking around my computer screen. Alright, he reaches level 3 before me, and so I have to back up. I use Acid Hunter to pick up the CS, because I have a lot of mana, and I just, for the most part, allow him to push it to me. I prep the minions and try to keep them away from the turret, though. So I reached level 3, Jace decides to ward, and I hit a Noxian Corrosive Charge. That allows me to keep him zoned out. He doesn't lose any CS from that, but he does go to half HP and uses his health potion. Unfortunately, I am going to miss that one CS. Now, when caster minions are at full health, after they've hit, taken a turret shot early in the game, you need to use an Acid Hunter to finish them off, because one auto-attack simply won't do it. Alright, so I'm able to hit another Noxian Corrosive Charge and keep him down. I unfortunately do not shield in time to negate the Shock Blast. Try to... Did it again. Try to negate his poke as much as possible, because Jace's only countermeasure of your poke is his lifesteal, and of course potions. Alright, so pretty soon I'm going to hit another Noxian Corrosive Charge, and realize this is the time. I'm going to pop Ghost immediately, because I see an opportunity to kill him. One of these days. Alright, he's in a very difficult position because he's forced to go either way. Oh, well, of course, you need to get your opponent down before you go all in, of course. I keep saying that. But now, he's low, Pop Ghost, he's going to push me back, but I can continue on. There's a minion right over there. I could have risked flashing and auto-attacking, but I had the potential of hitting a minion. However, I pinged a Moomoo earlier on, and he decided to be adventurous. So we picked up that kill, and Jace ends up missing a lot of CS. I've got enough gold for a Brutalizer, but of course I don't know this, but Jace picks up 3 Doran's Blades. I end up going for sustain, because I know that Jace is going to be in the lane for a long time, because the champion generally builds a number of Doran's Blades. Brutalizer would allow me to potentially kill him quickly, but this gives me much greater power over time. I also pick up a couple potions if I haven't had those in my inventory. So the lane is pushing to me, and I decide to keep it that way. There's no reason for me to lifesteal, and well, that is a mistake, kind of. I tried to get a Noxian Corrosive Charge onto Jace, but instead ended up lowering the health of all the minions. Even so, that kind of helps me dictate the lane movements by making sure it doesn't go all the way into my tower. So he hits his Shock Blast, and I hit my Noxian Corrosive Charge. Overall, about a fair trade. Because I have 2 Doran's Blades now, it's much easier to CS under the tower. Now, Jace started with a Fairy Charm, and that means that overall he's going to have a lot less mana than I, because I have a tier. We both missed a bunch over there, and ultimately I just won that mana trade, because he doesn't have much many avenues of sustain. After I miss my Noxian Corrosive Charge, Jace decides to go all in on me. That's a pretty good idea, but well, I use Hyperkinetic Position Reverser, and that gives me a ton of temporary stats, but once they go down, Jace tries to turn, and if I had stayed there, then he potentially would have killed me with his auto-attacks, so instead I walked out, and then once my E comes back, I'm going to flash in, and just in the range of Noxian Corrosive Charge, EQQ. You've got to recognize opportunities like that. And that just comes with practice. So I'm going to leave the lane as is so that it pushes towards my tower, because in that way, Jace loses more minions than I do, and I keep it in a much more safer position. And it guarantees basically that I don't have to blow any summoner spells on escaping ganks. So bot lane's about to lose their tower. That's going to open up the dragon for the enemy team. At this point, I didn't have enough for Brutalizer, so I decided to pick up 2 longswords and boots. I could have gone for, say, a Crystalline Flask in place of the boots, but I figured that dodging Jace's attacks would probably be a bit more beneficial. Okay, so Jace is going down to roam into mid lane, and I don't know this yet. I think that he's probably sitting in a bush like he always has been, but then I notice he's not there. So I immediately decide to head down to the mid lane area, And we've got Alistar. It's basically 3-on-3 over here, but they have a very large chance of winning this trade. So I come up as fast as I can. Once I hit this point, I'm going to Ghost. I see Vi, EQQ, she's dead. I'm going to use Hyperkinetic Position Reverser on Ryze, because that'll keep him away from the tower. Flash is going. Alistar is going to Flash and Exhaust. That isn't really necessary, but I can see its use. In any case, we get a double kill and decide to go for Dragon. Amumu was trying to counter jungle. He used his smite, but it should be up pretty soon. And Vi is in no position to contest. So, always make sure to use Alexine Corrosive Charge on the drag, because that allows your team to do so much more damage. Because it reduces armor by 12% at level 1. And of course, living dangerously. Kids, don't do that. Don't recall there. Something almost happens here, but not really. The lane is pushing towards their tower, so I decide to roam mid. Of course, that's also because there's a very large team over there. They grouped up. And I picked up a Brutalizer and a Longsword. The Longsword is to build into the Last Whisper. So I hit a Nox and Corrosive Charge on Ryze, but I'm trying to stay away from Vi, because I'm not sure about Vi's ultimate at this point. It's going to be up soon. Alright, so this is typical. After a push in mid lane, the enemy's very likely to just walk off and do other things. Well, you can use this to your advantage. And, of course I try to make something here. Unfortunately, I missed Nox and Corrosive Charge. And, well, ultimately, nothing happens. Ryze decides to go take Wraiths while I try to flank. And, that only works sometimes. But Jace is up top lane again, pushing it in. And I intend to get there soon enough to clear out those minions and prevent damage being dealt to the tower. If I had summoner spells, I would have chased Jace down because I would have been able to kill him before he got to the tower. But alas, that was not to be. Dragon, when is that up? I can't see the timer. Ha, ah well. So the enemy team is pushing down the mid lane, and Kog'Maw's down there, trying to take out that tower. So I decide to just follow through, help clear the wave, and see if anything can be made. Amumu living dangerously, Bandage tosses in, goes for it. My ultimate is stopped by Sona's whatever it is. But even so, I gain defensive stats, which forces them to mostly focus Alistar. And we chase them down a little bit. Ryze flashes in. That's a really good intervention. Kog'Maw's on the flank, but we aren't really in a position to follow up. However, I tried to go for it. I can't take much damage, so I just chase them down. Unfortunately, Kog's about to die. But see, it's only two of us, and three of them, but they're pretty low. I mean, so are we, but we have a lot of potential here. If I can hit a Nox and Corrosive Charge on one or two of them, we can kill them. Lo and behold, two. So, I hit two of them, flash into range, and then with my passive damage reduction, Jace cannot kill either me or Kale, and we can push down the way. Of course, with how much gold I have, ooh, that's almost enough for a Last Whisper. Actually, it is now. I decide, I'm thinking of recalling very soon. That damage on Vi is Noxing Corrosive Charge and two Acid Hunters. Pretty considerable. Ghost is up. Amumu decides to give me Red Buff. Much appreciated. And soon I'll be recalling to get that Last Whisper. My Tear of the Goddess is only at 431 stacks, so There isn't much of a reason to pick up Matamune yet. Okay, so because I see Jace in top lane, I decide to head over there and help out. However, there's a brawl going on in mid lane. I'm not sure why, given that two players that kinda should be there are completely missing. But anyhow, Jace is trying to decide whether to group up with his team or stay in lane. And once he sees me, I guess he decides to go with the team. I should be following up very soon. What's Jace doing? Okay, so he wants to clear the... Right. So, with them completely overextended, I decide to come right in. Speedy God's about to pop Ghost. Did they kill him? No, they almost did. Alright. When leading up to fights, it's really great to pop Ghost if you need to chase enemies down. It gives you so much speed, and you can ultimate Rise. That gets him away from the tower range, and allows us to completely take him down. So Dragon's going to be up pretty soon. We're looking to push down mid, and then rotate straight over there. Jace is pushing up top lane, but that's a non-issue. You can basically just forget about him. That's quite a bit of damage, because Caitlyn walked out of range of the tower after I used Acid Hunter. The aggro was not getting top. It didn't aggro me. So my team decides to push bot lane, even though we only have 3 minions over there. They're looking, it seems, to get a couple kills, but that's not really happening. So after meandering around, wasting a little time, we decide to go for Dragon. Now this is a lot of gold right now. I have 1,320, and to upgrade to Manamune, I need 1,500. So, selling Adorn's Blade is perfectly within reason. And that will allow me to build up the stacks very quickly, and hopefully get a very large power spike pretty soon. So at this point, after purchasing, our best bet is to group up somewhere, and possibilities would be mid lane, that's the obvious one, but additionally in top lane, there's some free gold in that turret, so why not pick it up when we can? It's the safe way of securing a lead. So after pushing out mid, getting the blue buff, we decide to head up to top lane. Of course we do get separated because these two want to push out mid, but in any case, we had it up top, and, well, dangerous. Jace was trying to pick up a set of trap, but the rest of his team wasn't nearby, so what happens here is my team just discovers the entire enemy team, and brawls with them. I run in. Ghost isn't up, but I still have Flash. I should have ulted Caitlyn right there, but in any case, it's a favorable trade for us. If anything, well, if we weren't so far ahead, that would have been a pretty stupid idea. But as it stands, we are fine. So how much gold? Only 670, that's enough to purchase boots. Could go for Mercury Treads or Ninja Tawa in this game. Though I'd also want to get some tank values with Kindle Gem or Glacial Shroud. In this case, probably Kindle Gem, given that Rise is so much stronger than the rest of his team. So, I see that I have Ghost and Flash up, and I'm gonna make an opportunity over here. If Vi, Vi realized that I was probably far away from my team because I was meandering around, and, well, that was kind of beside the case. They were outside of their vision range though, so it was kind of a good idea on her part. However, I flashed into my team and didn't allow anything. I've got quite a bit of gold now, and I'm looking to recall. That blue buff around me is a fake. So at 20% CDR, I'm looking to reach 30%. That's why I built a Kindle Gem. That's going to be later built into Spirit Visage. My Mana Mune is almost completely charged, so I'm going to keep using that. Generally, you'll find it charged all the way at about 22 minutes or 23. And that's a point in the game when you have enough mana to actually, well, use it. So, we kind of want to avoid Baron. We can bait them into thinking we're taking Baron and then just jump on them through a trap. But overall, we just want to pick up some farm and then head over to the free dragon and push down mid. Remember not to push leads too far. Like, don't just rush down the mid lane just because you have, say, a 3,000, 4,000 gold lead. Just try to gain objective control and obtain a much larger gold lead until, well, before you actually go for the finalizing blow. This will stop you from throwing a lot more. But anyway, because their jungler was out of position, we decided to go for Baron and try to push it down. Well, try to catch them. It didn't really work, so we can either push down mid lane or get dragged. My cat's moving around my desk and pushing things. That's interesting. So I get a good Nox Corrosive Charge, EQPQ combo off on Rise, and I've realized how much I love having Kog'Maw in my team composition. The poke is just incredible. So, okay. This is a highly questionable move by Vi, but it can make sense. See, they're very far behind, and they need to make something happen. Both Kale and I are farther away from them, and they think that perhaps if they can get a pick, they can make something happen. But I rejoin the team as soon as I possibly can, and Kale does the same. And so, without enough time to follow up, they are pretty much screwed. And from here, we can push down the turret, inhibitor, and from here, win. I finally upgrade Urumuna, so this, of course, is the right time to miss all your skill shots. And yeah, I hope this was educational, helpful, maybe even. And if you liked it, leave a comment, like, subscribe. If you have any complaints or suggestions or what have you, please leave a comment. And peruse the rest of my videos or the guide if you are interested in learning Argot. So, I'll be trying to release content much more often, and I'll gradually get better and better at it, rest assured. And, oh, I would like to show you one thing. You see, that game was quite interesting. See, As Urgot, with the positional advantage you gain from Ghost and Flash, you can run around in teamfights and get a very large amount of damage onto enemies while taking very little because of your cutting capabilities. Now, overall, I did the most damage, and this seems kind of strange for an Urgot, given, there's Kog'Maw and Kale, but that actually happens quite often. Because you don't die, because you don't use Hyperkinetic Position Reverser to just die in a teamfight. And because of my kiting, I ended up taking the least damage in my team. So consider playing that way. Try to take very little damage. If anything, just take a little with your shield and then walk out. So anyway, thanks for watching and have a good one.